I want to go over to CNNI's Errol Barnett. He is dealing with this new announcement from Steve Jobs of Apple about a new tablet. It's called the iPad. All we know, or all I know so far, is that it's about 10 inches. It's a big screen. Errol knows everything else. Errol, what have you got on this?
Well, the most important details just come across, Ali, and that is the price of this device. It will run you as low as $500 for the smaller model. The larger model with more memory is about $700. That news just coming into us. Let me give you some other details anyone interested in this device would want to know. That you'll have to wait until you can get it. It takes anywhere from 3 months to get to you for the large 3G models and about a full month to get to you for the non-3G models. The data plans for 250 megabytes per month, it costs $15 per month, and unlimited data for $30 a month. AT&T will remain the provider, and they will allow free use of Wi-Fi hotspots as well. No contracts, cancel anytime. But Ali, on this news, if you look at Apple's share prices, they've actually fallen some 4%. But there are some specs of this device that make it stand out. Nothing groundbreaking, though.
Interesting. So it's not the look. It's always Apple, sort of always on a steady plod ahead into something bigger and better. But you're saying people are disappointed that it's not as much as they thought it would be, not as big a deal as they thought it would be.
Well, look, what Apple does when they approach this kind of event is they say and reveal absolutely nothing until the moment Steve Jobs takes the stage to build anticipation. The only noteworthy thing I would pull away from this is that they're releasing something called e-books. That essentially makes this iPad a direct competitor with all the other e-readers out there, Amazon's Kindle, for example.
Right.
If you rewind to this Christmas, more e-books were sold through Amazon than physical books. So Apple wants to capitalize on that seismic shift. The device, I have some papers here, this is not it, but it can be in the landscape or portrait view, which allows you to read newspapers and magazines, also academic books as well, Ali. So Apple is hoping to hang on to its existing customer base, the folks that love iTunes, the folks that love Google Maps and all the other applications, and then build on that with e-books and other people who enjoy reading their newspapers and magazines on the device. So this iPad, seismic shift, we'll have to wait and see, but they did keep the price below $1,000, which many analysts believe they would need to do to attract you and I, any regular Joes, to even think about purchasing this.
Right, and that's, these are early adopter prices, as we saw with Kindle. They come down pretty quickly. If you get your hands on one of those, Errol, you come right to me.
I'll hang on to it for a short while, and then you'll be the next person.
All right, buddy. Errol, good to see you. Errol Barnett at CNN International.